We're here, folks. We stand before the African Meeting House, the African Baptist Church, 1806. We believe it to be the oldest black church building in the nation. Brought into being by some blacks who had been allowed, actually, to have some of their worship services at Faneuil Hall. And then they wanted to form a church. And then, of course, built this place and opened it in 1806. This place is full of the spirits of people who were here and whose remarkable stories are there in that building. This is where the recruitment of the 54th Regiment began. This is where in 1832, the New England Anti-Slavery Society came into existence under the leadership of Garrison. This is where 6 years before that, in 1826, the Massachusetts General Colored Association was begun with David Walker and others. This is where Mariah Stewart made some of those very first speeches ever made by any woman in the United States, were speaking against slavery, because women weren't supposed to do that. It's where almost any black leader from the 1800s whom you can mention appeared more than once. It's where Lewis Hayden gathered the community to defy the fugitive slave law. And we could go on and name person after person. And this place is full of those spirits. I have had so many occasions when in this very building, people today have had real spiritual experiences. I can tell you of an African woman who came on a tour one day. She was simply out shopping. And she came by the monument up there, Shaw Memorial, where we were, carrying a big paper bag with all kinds of things she'd bought. She had no idea she was going to go on a Black Heritage Trail, she told me, but she came with us. She was in town because she was an actress in Vagina Monologues. And she got into this place, this meeting house. And there she said to me, after she heard its history, "This is a place for declaration." And I said to her, "Would you like to make a declaration?" And she stood up there near the pulpit and she cried, sobbed, regained her composure, and made a declaration to use her acting skills in a furtherance of the purposes of those men in the 54th Regiment and those other spirits which were here. I've had numerous experiences like this. A very mixed group of young children, mostly Asian, African, Hispanic, and they heard the story. They sang a hymn. Do you know what they sang? They sang "Lift Every Voice," the African National Anthem. Right here in this place is very important when we think about history.